PowerDirector 16, let's mess with some color boards and see how that turns out. I've actually got a video here, and all I'm doing is grabbing this and stretching out the timeline. I want to put some text up here in the right side, and then I want to have like a background color. So first, is I'm going to go over here to text. I'm going to click that first. And then I'm going to drag this one down to my timeline. So I'm going to put this over here. I'm going to double click it. So this way it opens it up. And then I'm going to select a font over here. So I guess I'll select, this yellow one. Double click in the box here. And then I'll put this where I want it. Now, that looks fine, but I'd like to have a background color on that too is what I would like. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here to my left side. I'm going to click back on my disk. And I'm going to click this arrow right here and I'm going to open this box up. And you see where it says color boards? I'm going to click that here. And then I'm going to select a color board that I want for my background. Now probably, I don't know, probably a yellow is probably going to look pretty good. That's what I'm going to do. And you notice I'm putting that underneath it there? Okay. And we can grab the corners here on this. And we can shrink it down. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click it. And I'm going to enter the PIP designer room. And this is under object settings. There's a place here that says maintain aspect ratio. You see that right there? I want to uncheck that. Because then it allows me to set this box any size I want. I don't have it trying to keep everything proportioned. Now in the same area over here, I'm going to work in opacity. And by turning that down, it's not going to be so dark. And you see now the word show me is showing up. So I could probably take that down to probably about 50%. Hit okay. And now I've got like a background to it.
And we're supposed to go down to...
See that? Now if I want to get pretty fancy with it, what I could do is... double click on my color yellow. And in my other video I showed you how to fade in, fade out, so I could enable that, which is down in the bottom left. And then hit OK. So now I can fade it in and fade it out.
We're supposed to go down to
So that looks kind of cool, doesn't it? Don't forget, we still want to set the fade level.
And we're supposed to go down to what'd they say, like.
So that's a pretty cool effect, how that actually comes in like that. But what if I switch them? Okay.
And we're supposed to go down to...
So you see how that's going now? So I'm going to go back in here because I put my... text on the bottom, I put my yellow on the top, switched them around. I'm going to double click it and go back in here. And this time I'm going to take my opacity and move it way up. And now the words are sitting on a dark color. So depending on which way you really want to do this, you can make your actual text stand out better by using color boards within PowerDirector 16. And depending on where you put it on your actual timeline. Let me unlink the music here. Or me talking, I mean. So now I'm going to move this over. I'm going to move this over. We'll extend this way out now. And you can select any text you want. You can select any color board you want. Just keep in mind that when you're actually in the edit mode with the desk clicked here, make sure the arrow, you haven't forgot that arrow there to pull them out. And I have to go back to media content if I want to see what's in there. If I forget to do that, when I have color board selected and then I close it, I'm not going to see my media content. I'm going to be like, well, where did they go? What happened? So make sure when you're done with selecting whatever color board you want, make sure you go back to selecting your media content. And now you can put text on the screen in PowerDirector 16. You can have it fade in, fade out. You can have it sit in the background, sit in the foreground. Use your opacity, and you're off and running. And now you're looking really good. And all I did there was grab my keyframe and drag it out. So that way it shows up more. But if I don't want it fading in or fading out and I just want that solid color, again, I can just turn my fades off. And now my color board's gonna sit there the whole time. So I got my video going, then I ran my color board, then I ran my text. And this way I've got my text sitting on top of my color board. So there's another quick tutorial, guys, on how to actually mess with color boards in PowerDirector 16. If you want your channel advertised at the end of a tutorial, send me a private message and I'll put you in at the end of a tutorial in PowerDirector 16, and this way you get some free advertising. Head on over to the man cave. He's just learning how to backpack. He's just learning how to hike. He's slowly gathering his gear, and he's going to take you on his adventure of him actually learning. I don't think he's actually spent a whole night out yet. I think he's just slowly gathering his pack and getting his equipment together. So if you're interested in following something like that, you might want to check out the Man Cave. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.